Hi everyone, today we're going to look at how to create a poster in PowerPoint. Starting off with a new blank presentation, what I'm going to first do is get rid of the default text areas it gives you. So I'm going to select those and hit the delete key. Once I have a completely blank presentation, what I'm going to do is to format the slide so that it's the proper size. This is in kind of an odd place. Where I want to go is to the Design tab, then look on the right side of the Design tab ribbon to click Slide Size, and choose Custom Slide Size. There, I'm going to only change the values of width and height. I'm going to change my width to 48 inches, my height to 36 inches, and then click OK. It's going to ask me whether I want to maximize or ensure fit. It doesn't really matter which you pick, but I will pick ensure fit. Now it's time to start laying out my poster. But before I start laying it out, what I'd like to do is something that's pretty important, actually. I'm going to go to the View menu, and I'm going to turn on Guides. Guides are great. They are non-printing. However, they will help you align everything that we're looking to, have aligned. You can also turn on grid lines, but for the sake of today, I am going to not be using those. In order to get our initial layout, it's going to be a combination of two things mainly. It's going to be a combination of text boxes and rectangular shapes. For both, what I'm going to do is to go to the Insert menu. And for the title of our poster, I'm just going to use a text box. So I'm going to go over on the Insert ribbon. I'm going to click Text Box. And I'm going to click, hold, and draw out a long rectangle. The height doesn't really matter in this program. What matters is the length. I am going to pre-format this to make the text centered. And I'm going to make sure that the font is going to be legible. So I'm going to make my font somewhere between 80 and 100 points of size. So I'm just going to use 95. Now I can start typing. And now that I have my title, I'm going to hit return and put a little bit more information, such as who the authors are. And maybe where they came from. Once I have my title box filled out, I'm going to deselect it. And if I need to change anything with my text, I can just put my mouse over where that text is, click, and change what I need to. And I'm also going to change the formatting for my second line, which I don't need to be that big. Changing it from 95 to 75. And that's my text box done. What I'm going to be doing next is putting in the columns that all my information is going to go into. I'm going to be doing this in either three or four columns. For the purposes of today, we're going to be doing three. And I'm going to be doing this through the Insert menu part of PowerPoint. And in the Insert menu, I'm going to be drawing two types of things. I'm going to be drawing out shapes to define the clear borders of our columns. I'm going to be using the text box again in order to get text in there. Starting with shapes, I'm going to click on the Shapes button, choose Rectangle, and I'm going to draw a rectangle. The actual size of the rectangle you're drawing out doesn't matter that much because we're going to be changing a few things. The first thing we're going to change is the shape style. I don't want this to be a blue background, or if I do, I can do that later. For now, I just want this to be a white fill with a black outline. So I'm going to click on the bottom little button here under Shape Styles. And I'm just going to pick the very first thing in the theme. White fill with a black border. Then also, because I know from doing some of these posters, I'm going to change my width here in the shape format part of the ribbon from whatever it is to 14.5. I'm going to hit enter. And I can make any adjustments, make sure that I have enough padding on the sides. I don't want this to go past an inch, by the way. And I am going to go ahead and copy this. So I'm going to select that shape, make sure it's selected, and I'm going to hit Control Command on a Mac, C, and Control Command on a Mac, V. That has created my second column, which I can just drag to be a little bit out of the way, and I'm going to paste one more time. Drag that a little bit further away as well. Then, once I have all three columns, I'm going to let guides help me. So I can actually just move these columns till I think they're about the right place, and let guides let me know when they're the same distance away from each other. And to finish up our basic formatting, I'm just going to add a few more things. Mainly, I want to put in some column headers. So I'm going to go back to my Insert menu. I'm going to be doing the same thing we were doing before. I'm going to add a shape, rectangular. I'm going to draw this at the top of the first column. I'm going to leave that as a blue fill for right now. I am, however, going to change the height to 1.5. Then I'm going to add another thing, a text box. I'm going to draw that right inside that blue shape. Give this a decent size here. Let's try 48. Centered. And I'll make this the abstract. I'm going to select that text. Since it's on a dark background, I'll make its fill white. And then position it. And now that I have my first header, I'm going to do the same thing I did with the columns. I'm just going to copy and paste this across the other two columns. I'm going to select my shape, hold down the Shift key, click on the text, and then copy, paste. I'll do that one more time. I'll let guides snap that in. And the final thing I'm going to do is to add just a few text boxes to as placeholders inside those columns. So I'm going to go back to my Insert menu, back to my text box, and I'm going to draw a text box in the first column. And I have some lorem ipsum I can just paste in there right now. Now I'm going to hit Control, Command on a Mac, A, to select all. Now I'm going to make that text, well, larger. Then I'm just going to copy and paste this text area from the first column, paste, drag it into my second column, paste one last time to drag into my last column. And that's all we need to do for our basic formatting. Now that I have the basic setup for my poster completed, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill out the rest. I'm going to go ahead and change some of these titles. And the next thing I'm going to do is take some of this text away. I actually have a little bit too much text, so I am going to delete this. And I'm going to remove a bit of text here. And I'm going to put this text, I am actually going to cut it from here for something I'm going to do in a few minutes. The next things that I'm going to put in are some images. So to insert images into your poster, what I'm going to do is go to the Insert menu, go to Pictures, and I have some pictures ready on my computer. So I'm going to say from this device, and I'm going to grab a pie chart. This pie chart is already pretty close to the size that I want. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move it over here to this white space here. And I'm going to resize it a bit. When resizing images in PowerPoint, what you need to do is to hold down the Shift key on your keyboard, grab it by a corner control point, click and hold, and drag until it's the right size. And again, the arrow keys on your keyboard with a selected asset, in this case an image, I'm just going to click that, the arrow keys on my keyboard, until that image is in the correct place. I'm going to do that one more time. I'm going to add another chart to the middle of my methods column. So I'm going to go to Insert, Pictures, This Device, choose the next one, which is quite a bit bigger. But no problem, because I'm just going to grab it by that corner control point while holding down the Shift key, till that's the size that I want. Then, I have some text sitting in my clipboard right now, so I'm going to go ahead and find a home for it. I'm going to go to Insert, Text Box, to add yet another text box. Draw out that text box. Guides will help me put it in the correct place. And then I don't want to just hit paste. I'm actually going to do a paste on the home part of the ribbon. And I'm going to pick Keep Source Formatting. That's going to give me that other bit of text. I'm going to grab that. I'm going to do a few small adjustments. And don't be afraid of having white space in your document. It's fine. This makes the poster easier to read. It doesn't feel cluttered, which is all good stuff. And to round out the other images that I wanted to put in this document, I am going to go ahead and insert a few more things, some ISU logos. So I'm going to go to Insert, Pictures, This Device. I have an ISU seal, which I'm going to shift, drag, and find a good place for it. I'll just put it right here. Make sure that guides will let me know that that's centered. And I'm going to put in another one. Insert, Pictures, This Device, and find my longer logo. And that's my poster mostly done. At this point, other than some minor positioning and size adjustments, I've added a few things. One of the things I've done was to add an extra section to my third column here. But instead of, as in the second column, where I broke my text into two separate text boxes in order to create the space for my line graph, what I did was I went into my third column of text and I added a bunch of returns. This is not the ideal way to do it. I would prefer that you just always have separate text boxes when there is empty space, but I don't think the PowerPoint formatting police will come after you if you do it this way. I've also had to copy and paste another one of these headers down here in order to have my conclusion section. I've also added a references section to the bottom of my second column. I am not done with this, but we'll get to that in a moment. I did crop and resize my line graph, but I have not yet done so to my pie chart, which is where I'm going to start wrapping up this poster. In order to perform a crop on an image, I would normally suggest that you do that inside an image editor, but if you want to do it from inside of PowerPoint, that's perfectly fine. What I'm going to do is to first make sure that my pie chart image is selected. Then I'm going to go up to Picture Format, click on Crop. I'm going to get rid of a bunch of the white space to the right of the pie chart. and to the left of the pie chart. And once I think I have that cropped correctly, I'm going to click the Crop button again. Then, I'm going to go ahead and resize it to fill up this space a little bit more. Holding down the Shift key on my keyboard, and then repositioning it. The other thing that we would ask you to do is, if you took any of the images from a source other than your own, I'm going to add a credit to that image. So what I've done is I've created a text box, filled it with the artist's information, and I'm just going to grab it and attach it to the bottom of that pie chart. We'll get back to that as well in a moment. For my references section, what I'd like to do is to have it stand out a little bit more as a separate part of the poster. So I'm going to select the references area. This is just a text box. But PowerPoint does treat text boxes just like a shape box. So I'm going to click on the references box, make sure it's selected. And I'm going to go to shape format, to shape fill, and I'm going to add a light blue background to it. And at this point, I could say that I'm done with my poster. But before we get to saving it, I wanted to talk about just a few other things. One is, I want you to make sure that everything will look okay when it's printed. In order to do that, it's best to go to the View menu, click on Zoom, and look at your poster at 100%. Pretty much what you see at 100% is how it should look once it's printed. So by looking at all your images, I can see that the ISU seal looks nice and crisp. And if I have smaller text that I need to adjust, such as the credit underneath my pie chart, this will make it a lot easier for me to proofread or change any information that needs to be changed. But once I'm done making sure my images look nice and that all my editing and any proofreading is done, what I want to do is under the View menu to go back and click Fit to Window so I can see my whole poster again. And just a few last notes. On the subject of fonts, you really don't want to use more than 2 or 3 because the way this poster currently looks is better than something like this. So, a limited number of fonts just looks better. On the subject of color, I'd also suggest that you try and limit the number of different colors in your poster. For those colors you do have, make sure to keep high contrast between your information and your design. So, bright backgrounds for dark text and images, and vice versa. To change your colors, click on the asset that you want to change the color for. I'm going to click my title. Click on Shape Format. And to change the fill for that object, I'm going to click on Shape Fill. For this one, I'll turn that black. And for the text, Text Fill, which I will make white. To change the color of the poster itself, right-click on the slide away from any asset, and right-click, choose Format Background. I want a solid fill, and I'll make that, by choosing the color here, to be black. And now that everything's been proofread and we're happy with our poster, we need to save it out for printing. In order to do that, we're going to go to the File menu. And if you don't see a Save as Adobe PDF option here, I do suggest using that and you can just click OK once it gives you the dialog box. We're going to go to Save As, give our document a name, switch our format from PowerPoint presentation to PDF, and then, assuming we know where to find it afterwards, I'm putting this on my desktop, I'm going to click Save. And that should be it. Should be a PDF on my desktop that I can now send to the printer.